Bonjour tout le monde, merci d'être ici aujourd'hui. Je vais essayer de rester bref, je vais vous donner l'occasion de me poser des questions et aussi de m'assurer de ne pas être en retard pour le défilé de la fierté, qui est l'une des raisons qu'on est à Montréal aujourd'hui.
Before we get into things, I'd like to say a few words about two recent international tragedies that have touched Canada. At the beginning of the week, two Canadians, Tammy Chen and Bilal Defala, lost their lives in a terrorist attack in Burkina Faso. They were among 18 innocents who were killed. We've reached out to the families to express our sympathies as they grieve in this difficult time. And just a few days ago, there was another heinous act of terror on the streets of Barcelona, where 14 people were killed and over 100 injured. Among the dead is a Canadian, Ian Moore Wilson. Our thoughts go out to his family, as well as the four Canadians who were wounded in this attack. These recent acts of terror are despicable. They seek to divide the global community, aiming to pit neighbor against neighbor, stoking fear and mistrust. But these cowards will not win. We will continue to do as we have done, standing united and stronger in the face of hatred. We will be emboldened in our values, values of love, acceptance, and strength through diversity. My friends, in the wake of terror, let us never lose sight of who we are. Au début de la semaine, deux Canadiens, Tammy Chen et Bilal Defala, ont perdu la vie lors d'un attentat terroriste à Ouagadougou, au Burkina Faso. Ils étaient parmi 18 personnes innocentes qui ont été tuées. Nous sommes en communication avec leurs familles et leur offrons nos sincères condoléances en cette période difficile de deuil. Et il y a quelques jours, un autre acte terroriste haineux a été perpétré dans les rues de Barcelone, durant lequel 14 personnes ont été tuées et plus d'une centaine ont été blessées. Parmi les morts se trouvait un Canadien, Ian Moore Wilson. Nos pensées accompagnent sa famille et également les quatre Canadiens qui ont été blessés lors de cet attentat. Ces actes terroristes sont odieux. Ils visent à diviser la communauté mondiale et à semer la discorde entre voisins en attisant la peur et la méfiance. Mais ces personnes lâches ne vont pas gagner. Nous allons continuer à faire ce que nous avons toujours fait, à nous montrer unis et encore plus forts face à la haine. Nous resterons fidèles à nos valeurs, les valeurs d'amour, d'acceptation et de la force créée par la diversité. Mes amis, face à la terreur, ne perdons jamais de vue qui nous sommes. And I'd further like to address the situation at our border, at Saint-Bernard-de-la-Colle. Canada is an opening and welcoming society. These values have always defined who we are. But let me be clear, we are also a country of laws. Entering Canada irregularly is not an advantage. There are rigorous immigration and customs rules that will be followed. Make no mistake, we enforce them to safeguard our communities against security risks. J'aimerais aussi aborder la situation à la frontière à Saint-Bernard-de-la-Colle. Le Canada est un pays ouvert et accueillant, et ses valeurs ont toujours défini qui nous sommes. Mais permettez-moi d'être clair, nous sommes également un État de loi. Le fait d'entrer au Canada de façon irrégulière ne procure aucun avantage. Il existe de rigoureuses règles à suivre en matière d'immigration et de douane, et nous ne méprenons pas, nous appliquons ces règles pour assurer la sécurité de nos communautés. Merci. Now, the Taoiseach and I just wrapped up a great meeting, and there were several things on the agenda. Obviously, CETA is top of mind for both Canada and Ireland, with the agreement coming into effect 1 month from now. We talked about ways that the Canadian and Irish businesses can benefit from the greater market access that's coming and reaffirmed our support for the agreement's progressive provisions. Nous avons aussi parlé de notre attachement commun à la diversité. Les citoyens du Canada et ceux de l'Irlande savent que la diversité est une source de force, non de faiblesse. Nous comprenons qu'il ne suffit pas de simplement tolérer nos voisins, mais qu'il faut plutôt célébrer ce qui rend chacun de nous unique. peut s'agir de la langue que nous parlons, de la religion que nous pratiquons. Il peut s'agir de notre genre ou de notre façon de l'exprimer. Et oui, la personne que nous aimons fait partie de ce qui nous rend unique. I'm so proud to have Leo and his partner Matthew marching with me today in Canada Pride Montreal 2017. This is the first time a foreign head of government has marched in a Canadian Pride event, and it's particularly fitting given the close connections between Ireland and my city of Montreal, specifically. And the St. Patrick's Parade is our other great parade, and I certainly hope you see it at one point, but today everyone will be celebrating Pride. Every year, Montreal Pride events bring together millions of people gathering in peace and friendship to celebrate who we are. It's an event that reminds us that we are all part of the same community, and we need to keep fighting every day to ensure that no person feels excluded or unwelcome in this city or in any other community because of where they're from, because of what they wear, because of who they love. Bien entendu, Fierté Montréal est aussi une fête assez formidable et je suis très heureux de prendre part à ce défilé aujourd'hui ensemble avec mes bons amis irlandais ainsi que de partager cette ville avec eux. Je vais m'arrêter ici et j'invite le Taoiseach à dire quelques mots. Leo, please.
Merci. Premier ministre, bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très content d'être ici aujourd'hui à Montréal suite à l'invitation du Premier ministre Justin Trudeau. Ce n'est pas ma première fois à Montréal, mais c'est ma première fois comme Premier ministre d'Irlande, et je suis très contente d'être ici avec vous. I'm really delighted to be here in Canada today, representing the Irish government. And before I start, I want to express my condolences on behalf of the Irish government to Canada on the loss of your citizens in the terrorist attacks in Barcelona and in Burkina Faso. An Irish family as well was injured in the attacks in Barcelona, but thankfully we have had no fatalities involving our citizens. But it does remind us that terrorist attacks, by their very nature, target civilians, are indiscriminate and are odious and must be condemned without any equivocation. And Canada and Ireland will work together to defeat terrorism, but never allowing terrorists to force us to change our values and our way of life or to restrict our own freedoms. I'm visiting Montreal and Toronto for the next 3 days. Had the pleasure to meet with the Prime Minister just now, our second meeting. I'll be meeting with business leaders and investors over the coming days. There's about $3 billion in trade between Ireland and Canada every year, and that's growing. I'll also be engaging with the Irish community here in Montreal and Toronto. And as you know, there's a very established Irish community here in Canada, about 4.5 million people in Canada claim Irish descent, which is something that we're very proud of. And we're very proud of the extent to which Irish people have helped to make Canada the great country that it is. And also there's a whole new generation of Irish people, many from my age group, some of them my peers, who've come here to live and build new lives. And we want to particularly engage with them as well. And also I'll be engaging in some tourism promotion. Now that there are so many direct flights between Ireland and Canada, Canada is one of our top 10 tourist markets. We've had a 28% increase in visitors from Canada in the past 2 or 3 years, and it's been a record number for inbound tourism to Ireland from Canada. And I really hope that many more people in the years ahead will have an opportunity to visit both countries going in both directions, because we both live in fabulous countries that are really worth a visit. I think Canada and Ireland are countries that very much have shared values. We believe in openness to the world. We believe that free trade makes our economy stronger. We believe in personal liberty, in equality before the law, and also multilateralism as the best way to solve the world's problems and deal with disputes, whether it's conflicts or issues such as climate change. And I hope that this visit and future engagements will help us to bring Irish and Canadian relations forward, both in terms of investment and trade, tourism, business, and also political cooperation on key international world issues. As Prime Minister Trudeau said, the main thing that we discussed in our meeting was CETA, the Canada-EU trade agreement. As you know, that comes into effect on the 21st of September and involves the removal of 98% of tariff barriers to trade between Europe and Canada, which I think is an enormous change for the better in trading relationships between Canada and all of the European Union. So I'm here to promote that. Ireland is a country in Europe that is very similar to Canada in a lot of ways. We're English speaking, it's our main language. We have civil law, we're in the European Union, we're in the Euro, and we're staying. And we think there's a lot of reasons as to why Ireland in particular can benefit from this new trade arrangement between Canada and the European Union. So our government intends in the years ahead to expand our presence here in Canada. I hope to speak about that a bit more tomorrow in Toronto. We're already developing and increasing the staffing in our Enterprise Ireland office here. Tourism Ireland is here already, and we're going to expand our diplomatic bases here too, which I think is something very significant. One or two of our operations for Canada run out of the United States. I don't think that's appropriate. We should run our Canadian affairs from Canada, and we intend to do that entirely in the years to come. We also spoke a little bit about Brexit and NAFTA and updated each other on the talks that are underway in relation to those two items. Discussed a little bit about the Canadian healthcare system. As you know, Ireland is struggling to bring about improvements and reforms to our health service, whereas Canada has one of the best health services in the world. As the Prime Minister reminded me, it's far from perfect, and you do have your own problems, but I think Ireland could learn a lot from the success of the Canadian healthcare system, and I hope we can do that in the years to come. And we also discussed the issue of abortion, which I know is an important issue for a lot of campaigners for women's rights in Canada. We discussed that, and I updated the Prime Minister on our plans to have a referendum on that in Ireland next year to give the people of Ireland the opportunity to remove our constitutional ban on abortion should they wish to do so. And the intention is to have that referendum next year, ideally in the first half of the year if that can be done.